for the Union Dead, by Robert Lowell. About the author. Robert Lowell, 1917-1977, was a prominent American poet whose work had a significant impact on mid-20th century American literature. His life and career were marked by both literary achievement and personal turmoil, reflecting the complexities of the world around him. Lowell's early poetry was influenced by the New Criticism movement and was characterized by its formal structure and dense, elusive style. His first major collection, Lord Wearies Castle, won the Pulitzer Prize for Poetry and established him as a significant voice in American literature. Lowell continued to evolve as a poet, experimenting with different forms and styles. His later collections, such as For the Union Dead, 1964, and Notebook, reflect his ongoing engagement with historical and political themes. He remained a prolific writer, publishing several more collections and translations. Lowell is considered one of the most important American poets of the 20th century. His work, particularly his confessional poetry, influenced a generation of poets, including Sylvia Plath, Anne Sexton, and John Berryman. Lowell also taught at several institutions, including Boston University and Harvard, influencing many young poets through his teaching and mentorship. Robert Lowell's poetry remains a testament to his profound engagement with personal and historical themes, his technical mastery, and his willingness to confront the complexities of the human experience. His work continues to be studied and celebrated for its emotional depth and literary innovation. Significance of the title. The title, For the Union Dead, by Robert Lowell is significant for several reasons, encapsulating the poem's themes, historical references, and social critique. The title directly references the soldiers who fought for the Union during the American Civil War. Specifically, it honors the memory of Colonel Robert Gould Shaw and the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry, one of the first African-American regiments to fight in the war. These soldiers, often referred to as the Union Dead, symbolize bravery, sacrifice, and the struggle for equality and justice. The title sets the tone for the poem, which delves into the history and significance of their contributions. By using the word, for, the title suggests a dedication or commemoration. The poem serves as an elegy, paying tribute to the soldiers, sacrifices and ensuring that their memory is preserved. This act of commemoration contrasts sharply with the poem's depiction of modern society's tendency to forget or overlook the past. The title underscores the importance of remembering and honoring those who fought and died for noble causes. The title's reference to the Union Dead highlights the contrast between the valor and ideals of the past and the moral and cultural decline of contemporary society. Throughout the poem, Lowell juxtaposes the heroism of the Civil War soldiers with the apathy, materialism, and superficiality of modern life. The title, therefore, serves as a reminder of the values and sacrifices that have been lost or diminished in the present day. The title also reflects Lowell's political and social commentary. Written during the civil rights movement and the Cold War era, the poem critiques the prevailing attitudes and priorities of the time. By invoking the Union Dead, Lowell draws a parallel between the Civil War's fight for freedom and equality and the ongoing struggles for civil rights and justice in the 1960s. The title calls attention to the need for continued vigilance and activism in the face of social and political challenges. The title resonates with Lowell's exploration of personal and national identity. As a descendant of a prominent Boston family with deep historical roots, Lowell often grappled with questions of heritage and legacy. The poem's focus on the Union Dead reflects a broader meditation on what it means to be an American and how historical events shape individual and collective identities. The title places the poem within a literary tradition of elegies and commemorative works. By referencing the dead and their sacrifices, Lowell connects his poem to a long history of literature that honors those who have fought and died for important causes. This literary context adds depth to the poem's themes and enhances its emotional resonance. The title, For the Union Dead, is significant because it encapsulates the poem's central themes of historical memory, commemoration, and social critique. It honors the bravery and sacrifice of the Civil War soldiers while highlighting the moral and cultural decline of contemporary society. Through this title, Lowell calls for a renewed commitment to the values and ideals that the Union Dead fought for, urging readers to remember and honor the past as they navigate the present and future. Summary of the poem. For the Union Dead, by Robert Lowell is a complex and layered poem that weaves together personal memory, historical reflection, and social critique. Here's a detailed summary of the poem, stanza by stanza. Stanza 1. The poem begins with the speaker reflecting on the South Boston Aquarium, a place from his childhood that has fallen into disrepair. The bronze weathervane cod and King Philip represent symbols of a bygone era, hinting at the theme of decay and change. The ruined aquarium stands as a metaphor for the lost innocence and vitality of the past. Stanza 2. Lowell shifts to a more personal memory, recalling how as a child, he pressed his nose to the glass of the aquarium tanks, fascinated by the marine life. This nostalgic image contrasts sharply with the present state of the aquarium, now abandoned and neglected. Stanza 3. The speaker walks through Boston, noting the ongoing construction projects that signify urban renewal. The city is transforming, but Lowell views these changes with a sense of loss rather than progress. The giant finned cars and yellow dinosaur steam shovels symbolize the mechanical and impersonal nature of modern development. Stanza 4. Lowell then introduces the Shaw Memorial, a bronze relief sculpture commemorating Colonel Robert Gould Shaw and the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry, an African-American regiment that fought in the Civil War. The memorial serves as a stark reminder of the bravery and sacrifice of these soldiers, standing in contrast to the surrounding modern landscape. Stanza 5. The poem reflects on the history and significance of the Shaw Memorial. It captures the courage and determination of the soldiers who fought for the Union and for the cause of freedom. The speaker admires the memorial's ability to preserve the memory of these heroes, even as the world around it changes. Stanza 6. Lowell recounts the words of Augustus St. Gaudens, the sculptor of the Shaw Memorial, who expressed a wish that the monument would never be finished. This suggests an ongoing struggle and the idea that the fight for justice and equality is never truly complete. Stanza 7. The poem shifts to a broader reflection on the passage of time and the changes in society. The speaker observes how contemporary life has moved away from the values and ideals represented by the Shah Memorial. The focus has shifted to materialism and superficial concerns, symbolized by the new buildings and commercial developments. Stanza 8. Lowell juxtaposes the heroism of the past with the banality of the present. The sergeant's stare from the memorial is contrasted with the shaking skyscraper and the modern cityscape, emphasizing the disconnection between past and present values. Stanza 9. The poem continues to critique modern society, highlighting its preoccupation with consumerism and technological progress. The Boston Common is described as a place where people are more concerned with commercial photographs than with remembering their history. Stanza 10. Lowell returns to the theme of decay and loss, describing the remnants of the past that linger in the modern world. The Old South Boston Aquarium is now a parking lot, a powerful symbol of how historical landmarks and memories are being replaced by utilitarian structures. Stanza 11. The speaker laments the fading of historical memory, suggesting that the sacrifices of the past are being forgotten. The poem ends on a somber note, reflecting on the erosion of noble ideals and the rise of a more cynical and indifferent society. For the Union Dead, as a meditation on history, memory, and the moral state of contemporary society. Through its vivid imagery, historical references, and poignant reflections, the poem calls attention to the importance of remembering and honoring the past, even as the world moves forward. Lowell's elegiac tone and sharp social critique make the poem a powerful commentary on the changes and challenges of modern life. Critical analysis of the poem. Robert Lowell's poem, For the Union Dead, published in 1964, is a rich and multifaceted work that captures themes of history, memory, and social change. For the Union Dead is set against the backdrop of the American Civil War, specifically focusing on the Shah Memorial in Boston, which commemorates Colonel Robert Gould Shaw and the African American soldiers of the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry. The poem delves into the tension between past and present, highlighting the decay of noble ideals and the rise of modern, often more materialistic values. The poem is written in free verse, allowing Lowell to employ a flexible and conversational tone. This choice also reflects the chaotic and fragmented nature of the modern world that the poem describes. The irregular meter and lack of rhyme scheme contribute to the sense of disarray and disillusionment. Lowell's use of vivid imagery and symbolism is central to the poem's impact. The imagery of the broken windows and the Boston Common juxtaposes the decayed present with the heroic past. The aquarium, with its giant finned cars, symbolizes the loss of vitality and the mechanization of society. The Shah Memorial itself is a powerful symbol of sacrifice and idealism, standing in stark contrast to the surrounding environment. The tone of the poem is elegiac and contemplative, tinged with a sense of mourning for lost values. There is also an undercurrent of anger and frustration, particularly in the references to contemporary society's neglect of historical memory and its preoccupation with progress and consumerism. Lowell critiques the superficiality and moral decline of modern American society. He contrasts the bravery and selflessness of the Union soldiers with the greed and apathy of contemporary life. The poem reflects Lowell's disillusionment with the present, a common theme in his work, and serves as a lament for a more honorable past. The poem explores the relationship between personal and collective memory. Lowell's own reflections and memories are intertwined with the broader historical narrative, suggesting that the past is always present, influencing and shaping the current moment. The repeated references to historical figures and events serve to underscore this connection. The Political and Social Context of For the Union Dead by Robert Lowell is crucial to understanding the poem's themes and its critique of contemporary society. The poem was written and published in the early 1960s, a period marked by significant social and political upheaval in the United States. The early 1960s were a pivotal time in the civil rights movement. The struggle for racial equality and justice was intensifying, with significant events such as the Freedom Rides 1961, the Birmingham Campaign 1963, and the March on Washington 1963, highlighting the systemic racism and discrimination faced by African Americans. Lowell himself was an advocate for civil rights, and his poem reflects his awareness of these issues. The poem's focus on the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry, an African American regiment, serves as a reminder of the long history of Black Americans' contributions and sacrifices, often overlooked or forgotten in contemporary society. The poem was written during the Cold War, a time of heightened political tension between the United States and the Soviet Union. This period was characterized by fears of nuclear war, widespread political paranoia, and a pervasive sense of existential dread. The references to the huge finned cars and yellow dinosaur steam shovels can be seen as symbols of the era's technological advancements and the accompanying anxieties about their potential for destruction. The poem critiques the ways in which technological progress and consumerism have overshadowed more noble human values and aspirations. The poem also reflects the rapid urbanization and modernization of American cities in the post-World War II era. The transformation of Boston, with its new buildings and infrastructure, serves as a backdrop to Lowell's meditation on change and loss. The contrast between the historical significance of the Shaw Memorial and the encroaching modernity symbolizes the erosion of historical memory and the displacement of traditional values by contemporary, often superficial, pursuits. Lowell laments the decline of historical memory and the neglect of past sacrifices and ideals. The poem's opening image of the old aquarium being replaced by a parking garage is emblematic of this loss. It suggests that contemporary society is more concerned with convenience and progress than with preserving and honoring its history. This critique is further underscored by the poem's juxtaposition of the heroism of the Union soldiers with the apathy and materialism of modern life. On a more personal level, Lowell's own experiences and background influenced the poem. He was a member of a prominent Boston family with deep historical roots, and his work often grapples with themes of heritage and legacy. His struggle with mental illness and his opposition to the Vietnam War also colored his views on American society and its direction during the 1960s. For the Union Dead, is a powerful meditation on history, memory, and societal change. Through its rich imagery, evocative tone, and poignant social critique, the poem challenges readers to reflect on the values and ideals that have shaped their own world. It remains a poignant reminder of the complexities of progress and the importance of honoring the past. The political and social context of For the Union Dead provides a rich backdrop for understanding its themes and critiques. The poem reflects Lowell's deep concern with the moral and cultural state of America during a time of profound change and conflict. Through its historical references and vivid imagery, the poem calls attention to the importance of remembering and honoring the past, even as society moves forward. Themes. For the Union Dead, by Robert Lowell explores several profound themes, weaving together reflections on history, memory, and societal change. Here are some of the key themes of the poem. Decay and change. The poem contrasts the past with the present, highlighting the decay of historical landmarks and the rise of modern, often utilitarian, structures. The abandoned South Boston Aquarium and the transformation of the Boston landscape symbolize the broader theme of decay and change. Lowell mourns the loss of historical and cultural landmarks, suggesting that modern society often neglects its heritage in favor of progress and convenience. Historical memory. Lowell emphasizes the importance of remembering and honoring the past. The Shaw Memorial, which commemorates Colonel Robert Gould Shaw and the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry, serves as a focal point for this theme. The poem reflects on the heroism and sacrifice of these soldiers, contrasting their noble actions with the present society's neglect of historical memory. Lowell suggests that preserving history is crucial for maintaining a sense of identity and moral direction. Heroism and sacrifice. The poem celebrates the bravery and sacrifice of the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry, an African-American regiment that fought in the Civil War. The Shaw Memorial symbolizes their courage and dedication to the cause of freedom and equality. This theme is underscored by the admiration Lowell expresses for these soldiers, whose actions stand in stark contrast to the apathy and materialism of contemporary society. Social critique. Lowell critiques the superficiality and moral decline of modern American society. He contrasts the heroism of the past with the greed and apathy of the present, suggesting that contemporary values are often shallow and self-centered. The poem's references to commercialism, technological advancements, and urbanization reflect Lowell's concern that society is losing its moral compass and prioritizing progress over integrity. The passage of time. The poem explores the passage of time and its effects on people, places, and values. The transformation of Boston and the decay of historical landmarks illustrate how time erodes physical structures and cultural memory. Lowell's reflections on his own childhood memories and the changes in the city highlight the inevitable and often disheartening impact of time on human life and society. Conflict between past and present. Lowell juxtaposes the ideals and values of the past with the realities of the present, highlighting the tension between them. The Shaw Memorial, with its depiction of historical heroism, stands in stark contrast to the modern city's focus on commercialism and progress. This conflict underscores the poem's central concern with the ways in which contemporary society has strayed from its noble past. Human resilience and vulnerability. The poem touches on themes of human resilience and vulnerability, particularly in the context of the Civil War and the sacrifices made by soldiers. The Shah Memorial represents both the strength and the fragility of human ideals, as it commemorates those who fought for a just cause but also serves as a reminder of the ongoing struggle for justice and equality. Through these themes, For the Union Dead offers a poignant meditation on history, memory, and the moral state of contemporary society. Lowell's elegiac tone and vivid imagery underscore the poem's central concerns, calling readers to reflect on the values and ideals that have shaped their world and to consider the ways in which these have been eroded or forgotten in the pursuit of modern progress.